In the heart of northern Italy, just outside the sweet little town of Bogotaro, up in the mountains above Tivoli, you can have a one-of-a-kind experience and hunt for the infamous porcini mushroom, which is so precious that they are protected by the IGP. If you're lucky, you're with local guide Davide Costa of Trekking Taro Aceno, who is an absolute mushroom marauder. Davide gave us the rundown on how to spot these little morsels of joy as we stroll through this absolutely pristine landscape. As a professional environmentalist, Davide pointed out other natural wonders, along with the amazing varieties of fungi, some of which you can eat, some of which you can smell, and some of which will kill you immediately. All very exciting, but nothing more exciting than finding your very first porcino. This little guy was a picture-perfect porcini and a great first find, filling us with awe, wonder, and joy. We gave it its deserved Lion King moment, and documented it well for Instagram, before adding it to our little basket that was soon filling up with other porcini and edible delights from the forest floor. I can't really tell you the emotion you get from finding something in the forest that you can eat. It's very satisfying. Once we had our fill, we headed up to a very special place, the Chiesa di San Giovanni Battista, which is more than just fun to say. It's a unique two-tower church that has a peculiar little bar attached to it. Davide brought us up here to have a traditional post-mushroom hunt drink, at least that's what I'm calling it, and to see something very special on the wall, a framed signed photograph from James Gandolfini, who came here shortly before he died to visit the place his grandfather was from. Strangely, no one here really knew who James Gandolfini is because he wasn't famous in Italy. I guess they don't watch The Sopranos. Regardless, the people here are always proud to show off their land, which you immediately feel just looking around this cute little bar. Local soccer trophies lining the wall, the ever-present Catholic iconography, sweet little treats at the register, and positively ancient relics that are still working hard. Rounded out with some local art and, of course, photographs, some of which a younger version of our guide appears, and you instantly feel like you're in someone's home, which, in a lot of ways, you are. Davide pops open a bottle of Vino Spumante, and we all join in a toast to the late Mr. Gandolfini, his wonderful homeland, and the great porcini feast we're about to have. A drink later, we find ourselves at a mountaintop ranch, surrounded by ancient chestnut trees and green fields. Inside the home, a rustic kitchen, where we're going to learn how to cook all things porcino. Vitello al porcini, gnocchi al porcini, even a beautiful antipasto da porcini with local salumi. These were positively the biggest, the freshest, and the most insane porcini I have ever seen. And Master Chef Mauro was going to teach us everything about what makes these mushrooms so amazing, along with the best ways to eat them. One of which, my personal favorite, being fried. Here's how it goes. Beat up some farm fresh eggs. Man, look at those yolks. Then cut quarter inch fresh porcino slices. Bathe them in egg wash, massage them in some fresh pan grattato, and then pop, pop, pop them in some hot vegetable oil. Now wait until they're the color of a golden sunset. And then pop them on a plate and serve them up hot. Let me tell you something. There is nothing really finer than a fresh fried porcino, some sunshine on your face, and a few good friends as company. It's an eye-rolling good time. The end of this lavish and lovely meal was signaled by the appearance of some homemade grappa, which, when administered correctly, will ease any overeating that may have occurred.
Drunk?
Fourth day.
Of course, nothing can erase the beautiful memory of taking part in this ancient summer tradition here in Bogotaro, with such warm and lovely people. Thank you, Davide, thank you, Mauro, and thank you everyone, including the mighty porcini, that makes this region unlike any other in Italy.